Hello everyone and welcome to my channel and my first ever tutorial. Today I am going to show you a simple guide on how to change number of soldiers inside a unit. To start modding, you need to download a tool called Raster Pack File Manager. You can download from link in the description or you can follow the video. After downloading Raster Pack File Manager, you need to extract it. It does not need to be in Total War folder, it can be in a location of your choice. After you extract it, you can scroll down and click on Raster Pack File Manager exe as it is shown in the video. So when you first open the tool, it will probably be in white mode. I like to keep it in dark mode because I can see better. To put dark mode, go to Pack File, then scroll down to Preferences, click Settings tab and check Use Dark Theme, and then close the tool and reopen it. The first thing we need to do when we open Pack File Manager is to select a game we want to mod. In my case, I own Troy, so I will use Troy for this tutorial. Now, when we have selected our game, the next thing we need to do is actually create our mod. We do this by going into Pack File and selecting New Pack File, which will create for us the unknown.pack which we will use to edit units. Now we need to import units into our mod. We do this by right clicking the unknown pack, going add from Pack File. And now we go to original Total War game, in my case this is Troy, we go into data and then we choose DataDB, which stands for database. We open and we see in the next window that we have all the data from entire game. Now we search for main units, tables, and double click to move them to the left side. We do the same process for land units, because these are the two only tables that we can use in our mod for this tutorial. Now we can close this window and now we need to create our own two tables for our mod. How do we do this? We right click on the land units. Then after right clicking, we click create DB. Now we need to match the same DB as we chose, so in this case this is land units. We select land units tables and you can rename it so you know which part you are editing. We can type here my mod land units and click create. The same process is done for main units. Right click, create DB, and in this case this will be main units. We need to search for main units and rename it my mod main units so you can organize a bit better, so you know what you are doing. Now when we have our own tables, my mod land units and my mod main units, now we can add a unit we want to mod. So right click to the empty space, click add row and repeat the same process for land units. Now when we have created rows, now we need to use original data to import a deciding unit into our mod. We click on data and in the search we can type, in this case we will use Myrmidons, so you type Myrmidon and here you can see Troy Ptia Myrmidon Swordsman. Click on the number on the left so you highlight the entire row. Everything needs to be blue because if it isn't it will crash. Right click on it, copy, and then go to your mod table, click on the left, select entire row and click anywhere and click paste. To make things easier, we can organize what we see. So how do we do that? We right click and we click sidebar. And then in the sidebar we can hide almost anything and we can check the things we want. In this case, we are going to check unit and we are going to check number of men. We now have most important tables, unit and number of men, and as you can see, there is 80 men in Myrmidon Swordsman. We are going to change it to 1000. My advice is don't put too high numbers because your PC is going to explode. And then we can safely remove the original data pack. Now we can do the same process for land units. You select land units, you go to data, you search for Myrmidon Swordsman, same as before, you highlight everything, you need to copy. You go to your land units table, paste, overwrite everything, and now you can go to sidebar, just as before, so you can organize a bit better. And in sidebar, select key, and in this case, you select the number of mounts. You need mounts because in this tutorial we will not need that, but if your units have cavalry, and cavalry obviously has horses, then that unit with cavalry will be here. If main unit tables have 80 units, then it will be 80 horses in the number of mounts. Now we can remove data from land units tables. We no longer need that. Delete. We can go to main units. Number of men is 1000, too much, but for this video it will be okay. The number of mounts is 0 because there is no cavalry, and now we can save. We can click pack file, save pack file as. You can choose where you want to save it, rename it, and then you need to put it in your data folder inside your game. Is it Warhammer, is it any game it is, into the data folder. Now, after you place a mod in your data folder, it should be available in Mod Manager, and after you launch a game, it should be active. Now, let's see what happens in game. Let's see. As you can see, guys, we have 3000 people in 3 units. I hope I explained it well in my first tutorial, and thank you for your time, and stay safe, and see you in the next tutorial, guys. Stay safe. Bye.